Does bread land butterside down? Part 1. Science Experiment Series Video 1. The data and write-up for these experiments can be found at www.schoolfreeware.com. For these experiments, we'll need bread, butter, margarine, peanut butter, jelly, butter knife or rubber spatula spreader, balloons, curled paper, measuring tape, marker, toaster, and mop for cleanup. With any experiment, please use common sense and good judgment, and kids, get your parents' permission before making a mess. Experiments were done and a video was created. The data from the experiments pointed to the conclusion that bread is more likely to land peanut butter side down in several situations. Before the video's launch, it was learned that Mythbusters performed similar experiments in their television show entitled Is Yawning Contagious? Episode 28, Season 3. Clips of the Mythbuster experiment can't be displayed in this video because of possible copyright infringements, but to say that the copyright police are such wonderful people. Yeesh. Anyway, Mythbusters concluded that toast landed butter side up. The conclusions seemed to contradict each other, so therefore more experiments were conducted on the subject, and this video was created. Luckily, the scientific method allows for retesting of experiments and also allows for creation of new experiments. The idea that bread will land butter side down seems simple enough. When an object falls to the ground, there are a couple of forces that affect the object. One is gravity and the other is air resistance. Newton's second law states that the force of the falling object is the object's mass multiplied by acceleration, or F equals ma. Since acceleration is due to gravity, the formula may be written as F equals mg. A balloon and a penny will be used as an example. The balloon is represented in red, and the penny is in copper color. The balloon has a large surface area compared to the penny. An object at rest will want to stay at rest. Therefore, the air does not want to move, so the balloon has to push more air that does not want to move out of the way. The penny has more mass than the balloon. Therefore, the force of the penny is greater than the balloon. This allows the penny to move the air more easily, and having less air to move, the penny will fall to the ground quicker than the balloon. If a penny is taped to the top of the balloon, when dropped, the top of the balloon will have more mass than the bottom. The top of the balloon will be off balance or top heavy. The situation can be shown mathematically by stating that the top half of the balloon's force formula is F equals 1/2 mass of the balloon plus the mass of the penny multiplied by the acceleration due to gravity. The bottom half of the balloon's formula is force equals 1/2 mass of the balloon multiplied by the acceleration due to gravity. The top half will want to fall faster than the bottom half. So therefore, we expect the balloon to roll over and the balloon will drop penny side down. This example will be modified. The penny will be replaced by a slice of butter. The butter has more mass than the balloon and less surface area. Like the penny, the butter will fall to the ground faster than the balloon. If the butter was applied to the top of the balloon should turn over and fall butter side down. A marker was applied to the balloon's half that does not contain butter. Butter was then applied to the top of the balloon, and the balloon was dropped from a height of 4 feet. As expected, the balloon turns over and lands butter side down. Next, a balloon with peanut butter was dropped from the same height. Again, the balloon turns over and lands peanut butter side down. This experiment was done for a total of 10 times each. And each time, the balloon landed butter side or peanut butter side down. So therefore, if anybody wanted to know if buttered balloons land butter side down, yes, buttered balloons do land butter side down, and thanks to the wonderful technology of YouTube, your life is so much better knowing that. However, we want to find out if bread falls butter side down. So based upon our data and information, our hypothesis for the peanut butter bread experiments states that since one side has more mass the bread should fall favoring the side with the more mass, thus landing peanut butter side down. So hopefully, in your mind, you have something that looks like this. Here we have a diagram with a piece of bread with some butter and jelly on it. The unbuttered or jelly side is force equals 1/2 mass of the bread times the acceleration due to gravity. The other side is force equals 1/2 mass of the bread plus the mass of the peanut butter and jelly multiplied by the acceleration due to gravity. So when dropped, it should favor the buttered or jelly side and thus land butter side down. Within video 2, the experiments will be conducted and the data collected.